On the News Hour tonight, I'm joined by Dhananjay Kumar of the BJP. Mr. Kumar, thank you for coming. Justice Santosh Hegde, former Karnataka Lokayukt, senior most member of Team Anna. And we also have S.R. Hiremath, who's the petitioner in this case. The case in which this gentleman, Janardhan Reddy, has finally been arrested. First, Mr. Hiremath, did you expect this arrest to happen? When this happened this morning, many people were surprised and shocked. What was your reaction?
Well, my reaction is that we have been expecting this for quite some time. In fact, the arrest and the later jailing of Janardhan Reddy is an important milestone in bringing to book those who have been deeply involved in the Karnataka illegal mining scam, which is also on the border areas in the Andhra Pradesh.
Mr. Dhananjay Kumar, I remember the last time that we spoke. The last time that we spoke was before the Lokayukt report came in. And on this channel, you came and said that there should be an inquiry on how Times Now got the report. Your focus was on that. I'm sure you remember that. History tells you what happened after that. My only question to you is, how long can you continue to deny, obfuscate, see political motive behind anything to do with illegal mining?
Arnab, our stand is very clear. Now, Bharatiya Janata Party, the political affairs do not have to have anything to do with the private business being carried on by Mr. Janardhan Reddy. But that doesn't mean that we disown Janardhan Reddy altogether. Janardhan Reddy is a respected leader of BJP. He has been holding a high position in the government till recent times. And we only hope and pray that Janardhan Reddy will come out clean after proving his innocence before the court of law.
Why are you trying to avoid? Why are you trying to avoid? Trying so hard to avoid taking a position on his misdeeds, on his illegal mining. You're reading out a prepared statement, Mr. Dhananjay Kumar. You are not taking a position on the very serious charges that this man has been looting national assets. Please take
Arnab,
a position on that.
It is too early in the day to Arnab, it is too early in the day to come to any, jump into any such conclusions. Because after all, as per the process of law, now he is only an accused in the eye of law. The charges will have to be framed, charges will have to be proved to the hilt. Till then, he is supposed to be innocent. And all along, Mr. Janardhan Reddy has been claiming that he has never violated any of the law of the land. And he would abide by the law of the land. So he must be given an opportunity to prove his innocence before the court of law.
You are saying this because of the financial clout. You are saying this because of the financial clout he has. The financial clout which ensures that he dominates the BJP in Karnataka. You cannot speak against him because of the sheer financial clout which he commands.
I am sorry, Arnab. It is only a false assumption by our political opponents that Reddy's have been financing the party.
There was a charge against you that you went to Justice Santosh Hegde before the submission of his report, a charge you denied, to try and influence the outcome of the report in a manner that did not hit not just Yediyurappa, but also the esteemed members of his cabinet and other politicians like Janardhan Reddy. There is a backdrop to this.
Arnab, even today I stand by my statement that I have never gone to Justice Santosh Hegde pleading for mercy on anybody. I had gone to Justice Santosh Hegde.
Sir, Justice Santosh Hegde is
in
here.
Connection with another complaint,
sir, please,
which was lodged against me.
Sir, please.
Now, it is the truth which I can vouch for.
Sir, you can.
And you I can. Had even volunteered
the question
to
is not, no,
undergo
question,
a lie detector test.
Your question,
I mean,
you can continue to deny.
You
can continue to deny, but the fact is I want to get Justice Santosh Hegde here. Justice Santosh Hegde, I don't want you to give me an account of your private meeting with Dhananjay Kumar. Whether Dhananjay Kumar put pressure on you or not, or put in a word for Yediyurappa or for those who could be indicted in the report, it's your choice whether you want to comment on it today. If you do, it will be good.
No, I will comment. Please. Because I made a public thing about it. I would like to ask Mr. Dhananjay Kumar, who is a lawyer also, if he says that he has come to my house for the purpose of pleading a case against him pending before the Lokayukta, was he not trying to influence me then in regard to his case? Why did he come to my house? He should have come to my office.
Answer, Mr. Kumar.
What answer has he got for that?
Yeah. Yeah. Nanai, it was the goodness of Justice Hegde in allowing me to go to him and explain about my position in that particular case. And if Justice Santosh Hegde has any objection for that, I can only say I am sorry. Without his permission, I could not have gone there. I asked for his permission. He gave me permission and he also gave me patient hearing.
Okay. Well, question here is
nothing
this.
Nothing but absolute bunkum.
You heard that. I didn't say it, Dhananjay Kumar. Let me jump
I'm
on
sorry.
Me. I am
sorry for Justice Hegde using such words. I am really sorry. Today, the subject is something different. I would be available for a face-to-face discussion on that issue on some other occasion or not.
No, sure, but
today,
this is no, broadly.
The issue before us
okay, broadly.
Is about,
okay.
About
okay.
Janardhan Reddy.
No, okay. Yeah, you're Janardhan Reddy. On Janardhan Reddy, question is this. Because you made a point here and I want to get in Justice Santosh Hegde here. The point and charge of whether you tried to influence or not for the Yediyurappa will come to later. I assure you we'll have another debate on the news hour. My question to Justice Santosh Hegde is this. Justice Santosh Hegde, your report. Then the Supreme Court Central Empowered Committee report. Then the findings of this particular, you know, CBI, which has more or less corroborated what the Central Empowered Committee said on the violation of the mining lease. Is there much difference between, in terms of the moot issue, which Mr. Janardhan Reddy is accused of?
No, absolutely none. And now, if they were really interested in implementing the report, they would not have referred it to another committee of secretaries. This is all a game that they are playing. Ultimately, as Winston Churchill said, if you want to kill an idea, you refer it to a commission. That's exactly what they are planning to do. They are not interested. I submitted my first part of the report on 23rd of December 2008. There were specific recommendations against people concerned there, including Mr. Dharam Singh in that report. What action have they taken? I recommended both civil and criminal action against Dharam Singh to recover 23 crores of rupees that is lost to the state. They didn't get sanction from the governor, all right. Why couldn't they have filed a civil suit? No, they don't want. They don't want to take any action against their co-politicians. And the same thing that would happen here also. You take it from me, nothing will happen unless the Supreme Court steps in.
Well, the Supreme Court, Mr. Dhananjay Kumar, my question to you is, why are you avoiding a detailed discussion tonight on this channel? I find you, Mr. Dhananjay Kumar, avoiding a deep... Because, you know, I don't want to discuss generalities like other channels. I want to be very specific.
Please.
Hence, I won't ask you the same general questions you may have been asked. My question is, why are you, Mr. Dhananjay Kumar, avoiding a detailed discussion on the specific charges against Mr. Janardhan Reddy, who is known to be extremely close to and a big funder of the Bharatiya Janata Party? Why are you avoiding a specific discussion tonight?
No, I'm not at all avoiding. Arnab, before going into that, I would like to... To the best of my knowledge, I would like to plead before Justice Hegde that the report he submitted as Lokayukta is only a suggestion made to the government. It is not a judgment of a court of law. So immediately it cannot be implemented. It will have to be studied and the government will have to be advised how to proceed
taking
action against people who have been named there. Now for that purpose, the government has... set up a committee to look into that. And if Justice Santosh Hegde harps upon a point that whatever I have recommended should be immediately implemented, I am sorry, this is not the position of law.
I don't think he did that.
And the action what is to be initiated is left to the wisdom of the government.
Yeah,
the
sure.
government has the authority to go through the report and understand itself. And how to proceed about the
So we are to believe
mentioned therein, and the person against the persons who are named there.
No, so we are to believe
if that much discretion, if the government
so we are to
have,
believe.
I don't think how to proceed with
Mr. Dhananjay Kumar. So we are to believe that a novice chief minister will take on the might of the Reddy brothers, someone whom even the topmost BJP leaders have not been able to contain in terms of their clout. My question to you is again, why are you avoiding a specific discussion? Why are you avoiding a specific discussion? I have specific points. Is it true or not that there was illegal mining beyond the approved area? Up to a depth three times more than the permissible limit?
My understanding of the situation is not as what you understand it.
Sir, it is
Arnab, you please allow me.
Mr. Kumar,
I am telling you that we never consider Reddys as that much mighty so that they can...
No, those are all subjective things.
Here.
Those are
not
all subjective
all.
Things.
The point is...
Those are all subjective things, but you are refusing to answer my questions objectively. I am not making this up. I am quoting what is in the Supreme Court Central Empowered Committee findings. I can go to Mr. Hiremath.
Shall I make it very plain to you, Arnab? Shall I make it very plain to you?
Yes.
I can tell you that the BJP government in Karnataka will survive even without Reddys.
That's not what
more is required.
No, one second.
My point is, so long as Reddys remain loyal in BJP,
Mr.
and so long as they are our esteemed leaders, we would definitely support them.
Let me tell you, Mr. Kumar,
activities,
Mr.
not
Kumar,
for whatever they have.
Mr. Kumar,
please,
this country does not care. This country does not care whether Janardhan Reddy is in the BJP government in Mangaluru or not. This country does care if Janardhan Reddy and his ilk have been illegally mining our resources, violating our laws, creating a parallel empire, creating, you know, a system of payments, buying off politicians.
Judgment altogether, Arnab.
Yes.
Now it is too early now to pass a judgment.
Too early.
Now.
Okay.
Since the matter is before the court of law.
Okay, Mr. Hiremath.
Law requires. Many law requires, Arnab, that Janardhan Reddy also should get an opportunity of explaining his position.
Sir, there is a treasure trove of detailed facts about the Reddys.